Friends, today I am going to start a new subject of third semester mechanical engineering, that is mechanics of machines. Right, the first unit of this is basic kinematics in which we will not get any numerical problems, we get only theory. Right, you get one question of about 15 to 20 marks you will get in this chapter, in this unit. So I am going to start this basic kinematics in now. Now this subject deals with the forces which act on different parts of machines and the motion that is transmitted from one part to the other part. So this deals with this basically. So we are going to discuss this. Now we start with the definition of an element. Element. What's an element? Element is nothing but a part of a machine. A machine is generally an assembly of a number of parts. Each part of a machine is called an element, and this part may be one single part, it may be a single part, or it may be an assembly. For example, the piston and piston rod form one part because they don't have relative motion between the two. Since there is no relative motion between the two, as assembly of two or three parts where there is no relative motion among them, then it is called as an element, or it is also called as a link. It can be called as either an element or a link. Next comes pair, definition of a pair. Two elements which are in contact with each other are known as the pair. For example, the cylinder and the piston, they are in contact with each other. The cam and the follower, the bolt and the nut, these are all examples of pairs. Next comes kinematic pair, the definition of kinematic pair. What is a kinematic pair? Now, if the elements, there are two elements, in a pair there are two elements, if the relative motion between these two elements is either completely constrained motion, or it is successfully constrained motion, then that pair is called as a kinematic pair. Now, what is the meaning of completely constrained motion or successfully constrained motion? First, we will have to understand this. See, for example, I have a bracket. I have a bracket like this. This is one part, part A. Now, there is a hole here, a circular hole. Into this hole, I insert one rod of same diameter into this. This is part B. Now, this part A and part B form one pair. Now, here we cannot definitely say what type of motion B is going to have with relation to A, or what type of motion A can have with relation to B. Now, this rod which I have inserted here can move like this. It can also rotate. It can rotate as well as slide. Anything is possible, any type of motion is possible between these two, then it is said to be, the motion is said to be incompletely constrained motion. Incompletely constrained motion means the two parts in contact with each other can have more than one type of motion, more than one type of motion. They can, one can rotate inside the other one, one can reciprocate inside this one. So any type of motion is possible, then we say it is incompletely constrained motion. Now If there are two parts like this, they are in contact, they may be in contact with each other, A and B, but since the motion is not either completely constrained or successfully constrained, we say that it is incompletely, this cannot be called as a kinematic pair. This can be called simply as a pair, but not a kinematic pair, the pair between A and B. Now, I'll give you one more example. Suppose instead of a circular hole here in this bracket, I have made a square hole or rectangular hole, and in that I have inserted a square rod of same dimension here. Now this is part B, this is part A. Now you can tell me what type of relative motion is possible. Here the relative motion between A and B is only one type of motion is possible, that is B can slide with respect to A, or A can slide with respect to B. So only one type of motion is possible by itself, then it is said to be a completely constrained motion. Then it is said to be a completely constrained motion. Now this becomes, A and B becomes a kinematic pair. It can be called as kinematic pair. What is the meaning of successfully constrained motion? Now in the first case, I had taken a circular hole and a circular rod was inserted in that. Now this was B, this was A. Suppose on this end and that end, I put one collar either side, on either side of this bracket A, I put one collar. Now what I have done is I have restricted the motion of B with respect to A into only the turning motion. It cannot reciprocate. Now we say that the motion, relative motion between these two is successfully constrained, and when it is successfully constrained, that is by having a outside arrangement, I have made it constrained. So now it becomes a kinematic pair. If I do it, then it can be called as a kinematic pair. So this is the definition of kinematic pairs. Next comes the classification of kinematic pairs, the types of kinematic pairs. There are many types of kinematic pairs. Like we have lower pair, that means if the contact between the two elements, two links of a pair, of a kinematic pair, is a surface contact, if it is a surface contact between the two elements, then the pair is called as, the kinematic pair is called as lower pair. If the contact between the two elements of a kinematic pair is either point contact or line contact, then we call it as point or line contact, or line contact. Then you say it is a higher pair. For example, the flat belt and the flat pulley, or the cam and follower, they form a higher pair. Then we have a sliding pair, means one element can only slide, it can have only one type of motion, that is sliding motion. Then turning pair, then rolling pair. So these, depending upon the motion, spherical pair, like the mirror in a vehicle, there is a socket, ruler and socket joint about which it can rotate, the rear view mirror of a vehicle, automobile, that is a spherical pair, rolling pair, turning pair, sliding pair. Like this you can have, you can give the examples for this. Now similarly we have screw pair, that is bolt and nut is an example of a screw pair, and then it is also a lower pair. Then we have a self-closed pair, that is the contact between the two elements of a kinematic pair is by itself. We need not apply an external force to keep them in contact. then if we an external force is required to be provided to keep them in contact, as in the case of cam and follower, then it is called as force closed pair. So these are the different types of pairs that we get, kinematic pairs. So a kinematic pair means a assembly of two elements which have either completely constrained motion or completely constrained relative motion or successfully constrained motion between them, then they can be classified into these different types. Next comes a kinematic chain. After this comes kinematic chain. Now, an assembly of a number of kinematic pairs forms a kinematic chain. Kinematic chain is an assembly of a number of kinematic pairs. To form a kinematic chain, minimum number of kinematic pairs required is 4. Minimum 4 kinematic pairs are required to form a kinematic chain. Minimum 4 kinematic pairs are required to form a kinematic chain. Any kinematic chain with only 4 pairs is called as a simple kinematic chain. A simple kinematic chain. Now we have 3 simple kinematic chains, that is 4 bar chain, the 4 bar chain, 4 bar chain or quadricyclic chain, single slider crank chain, single slider crank chain and double slider crank chain. These are the 3 simple kinematic chains which are there, and we have only the study of simple kinematic chain. When a kinematic chain, is used to do a particular work, then it becomes a mechanism. It becomes a mechanism. Like we have a typewriter mechanism, indicator mechanism. We get in engineering, we get these mechanisms, typewriter mechanism, loco mechanism, different mechanisms we get. So these are got from the kinematic chain. Now we can get a mechanism by fixing one element of a kinematic chain. By fixing one of them, we can obtain a mechanism. Now next what we have to know is, we have to know the difference between a mechanism and a machine. When a mechanism is the simplest form of a machine, it is the simplest form of a machine. When a mechanism is used to do a particular work, it becomes a machine. This is the difference between a mechanism and a machine. And you are also supposed to know the difference between a machine and a structure. Machine and structure. Now, structure means a building. A building, a bridge. That is a structure. Any civil construction is called as a structure. In a machine also, it is an assembly of a number of parts. A structure is also an assembly of number of parts. But the difference here is, here we have input, we have output, we have efficiency, we get some useful work. Here the parts transmit not only forces, but they also transmit motion. Here in a structure, the parts of a structure are generally beams and columns. They transmit only forces from one element to the other element. They don't transmit any motion. There is no input, there is no output, there is no efficiency in the case of structures. There is no motion between the parts. Whereas here there is a motion between the parts. Now, we can get different mechanisms by fixing different elements of a kinematic chain. We can get from the same kinematic chain, we can get different mechanisms by fixing. Suppose there are 4 links, in a kinematic chain. There are four pairs. This is pair 1, this is pair 2, this is pair 3, this is pair 4. Minimum 4 pairs must be there. These are elements. This is element 1, this is element 2, this is element 3, this is element 4, something like that. If you have, now by fixing one element, I get one mechanism. Then by fixing, in the same case, this is released. If I fix this element, I get one more mechanism from the same chain. If I fix this, I will get another mechanism from the same chain. Now these mechanisms which we can get by fixing different elements by rotation from the same chain are known as the inversions of that mechanism, the inversions of that chain, inversions of those chains. Inversions means the different mechanisms we can get from a kinematic chain by fixing the different elements of a kinematic chain one after the other are known as the inversions. Now here we have three kinematic chains which are called as simple kinematic chains. These three are called as simple kinematic chains because, as I already told you, that in these chains there are only four kinematic pairs. Here all four pairs are turning pairs, all four turning pairs. Then it is called as a four bar chain. Here there are three turning pairs and one sliding pair. Out of four, three are turning pairs and one pair is sliding pair. Here it has two turning pairs and two sliding pairs. Then you call it as a double slider crank chain. Now you have the study of inversions. The inversions of these chains we have, that is, in four bar chain you get, these are the inventions that you get. Number one, you get a beam engine. This is one of the inversions of four bar chain. The couple loco coupling mechanism, and you have Watt's indicator mechanism. These are beam engine mechanism. These are the inversions of four bar chain. These three are the inversions of four bar chains. We get these mechanisms by fixing different elements or different links of a four bar chain. We can get these mechanisms. These mechanisms are well through animation. They are demonstrated in the YouTube. You get a number of videos which are there to show you this. You can go through it from the YouTube. You can search and go through it. It will be with animation, so in working condition, so you will get them. The second one is the single slider crank chain. As I told you, in this one pair is a sliding pair, single slider crank chain. In this one pair is sliding pair and three pairs are turning pairs. The inversions that you can get from this chain are the oscillating cylinder engine mechanism, then slotted lever crank, quick return mechanism, which is commonly used in shapers. in shapers we use this mechanism. Then you have Whitworth quick return mechanism. Whitworth quick return mechanism. Quick return mechanism, and you have Gnome engine mechanism. These are the different, they are called the inversions of single slider crank chain. You have to explain them. They will ask these mechanisms. You will have to explain them with a sketch. How it works, you will have to explain. If you see the animation of these mechanisms in the YouTube channels, different, there are number of videos showing these, you can get a better idea of these things. So I am not doing it in great detail depth here. This, all this, you will get only theory, you will not get any problem here. Then in double slider crank chain, you have here in this chain, we have two turning pairs and two sliding pairs. The inversions of this mechanism are the elliptical trammel, which can be used to draw in the drawing of an ellipse. Then Scotch Oak mechanism, which converts the reciprocating motion into Scotch Oak mechanism, reciprocating motion into rotary motion, or rotary motion into reciprocating motion, and Oldham's coupling, which is used to couple two shafts which are parallel, whose axes are parallel and slightly apart. Such shafts can be distinct by Oldham coupling mechanism. These three are the inversions of double slider crank chain. So these things, so either one or two of these mechanisms will be asked from here with a neat sketch. Explain these mechanisms. If you go through those videos, you can see them. You can see those mechanisms. You will understand it better. So I am not going to do it here. I have just given you the brief description of this. What I have told is what is an element or link, what is a pair, and what is a kinematic pair, types of kinematic pairs, then kinematic chains, then different types of kinematic chains and their inversion, the difference between mechanism and machine, and machine and structure. These things will be asked. They can be asked in theory, and you must be prepared to write them. Here I have not given sketches, I have not given this thing working, but you will have to do it. I request that you please share these videos and subscribe the channel so that you can get more videos.